Just these. I don't want the others.
Come on, man. I schlepped these all the way here.
There's people waiting.
You know, you don't have to be so disrespectful. You've actually carried my books here.
And you are?
Lee Israel.
Oh, we have copies of your latest work right over there.
You're rude, Lily. There's a grit to this movie. There's the shiny, pretty, and then there's New York I actually really love, and there's just more of a soul to it.
It's a world of books and papers and libraries and bookshops and dive bars.
I have figured out a way to pay my bills.
I'm embellishing literary letters by prominent writers.
I love his writing.
Particularly clever, don't you think?
Caustic wit.
So many of the bookstores that existed back in 1991 aren't there anymore. You know, they've fallen victim to internet purchasing and all the rest of it. And so it was a bit of a challenge trying to nail down the few that are left. The East Village bookstore, which had a little more of an underground punk rock vibe, Argosy and Armada, where they were much more higher end. So we try to paint a picture of Lee's world through the different bookstores that she frequented.
The places have this history that's just dripping from the walls. Some of them are hole-in-the-wall little bookstores that feel like they're gonna fall down, but they're so amazing. We're hopefully paying homage to these beautiful bookstores that used to be so much more frequent all over New York City, and a lot of them are the real places that Lee sold letters.
This is quite something. These are wonderful.
I thought so, too. The nerve she had going in and the pride she had coming out.
Name your price.
You were looking at 1 month's rent.
Wow.
It's a literary New York that the excesses of the 1980s forgot.
You really, really, truly feel what New York used to be and what it was to Lee. And I think that's a huge character in the movie.
I'll have you know, I'm a better Dorothy Parker than Dorothy Parker.
I'll drink to that. Cheers.